Welcome aboard.
But enough of this palaver. Let's get the show on the road.
Great. I was fully involved.
No kidding, man. Just can't have a mayor that says these things.
It's unbelievable.
I couldn't get enough. It was so fucking funny.
You can't have a mayor that types, would you let me come on those perfect tits? You just can't. And we're shock jocks.
Oh, we would, you know, yeah, the material we would get from Mayor fucking Danger.
Right.
Mayor Carlos Danger.
It's easy to take the angle, like, of course we want a mayor that talks like this, but you just can't have...
You don't think people would be taken seriously and work with him?
Jesus. Good morning, everybody.
At least he picked a realistic sounding name.
Carlos Danger.
Max Power.
Anthony Weiner is Carlos Danger.
Yep. He certainly is.
My God, he had a second chance. What the fuck's wrong with this guy?
I think he'd
society
okay.
gave him a second chance, which is so rare.
He'd have been okay if he had stopped and this was just some shit from, you know, a year ago, 2 years ago, whatever it was. But it turns out that this is new stuff.
When this broke once again on Twitter,
before
the mainstream news there, I'm like, oh, okay, they finally got some more old shit that popped up.
Yeah.
And then I'm like, what? Wait, what? He did this after he left Congress? What?
And his wife is standing next to him at his press conference yesterday.
And she was pregnant at the time that he went back in with this shit, right?
Jesus. She's looking up at him. He's fucking trying to look all contrite as she's giving her
Christ.
Speech about the fact that she loves him and believes in...
Look, man, I mean, I don't want to be part of a city where the mayor says things like I must have come thinking about you and looking at you 100 times. How does that make you feel? Gross? Question mark. I said I was hard. Help me. I just don't want a mayor that says things like that.
And if you're texting this stuff, you're not done.
Right.
You're not done. He's probably doing it right now.
By the way, anyone who wonders what sex addiction is, this is it.
He's addicted, right, Jimmy?
People are like, it's not addiction. This guy blew his political career.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
6 months later, he still couldn't stop.
He couldn't stop.
6 months, he went right back in after he left Congress,
like. Oh, he's terrible.
And then he's trying to say that he stopped in November.
He didn't stop.
There's no way he stopped in November.
People don't stop.
No,
when they're at this extent of
no. You really want a mayor that says standing behind you, lathering with one hand, fingering you with the other. I mean, go up to Albany and get some funds for the city, please.
Well, you know what though? This he makes a good point here.
Yeah.
God, I want to take you from behind in front of a mirror. I want to see your face and feel your pussy spasm as you come with me deep in you.
Can you imagine Mayor Bloomberg or Mayor Koch or...
Hey, God, I want to take you from behind. I want to see your face and feel... your pussy a spasm as you come with me deep in you.
Look, there's no goody two-shoes in this room, but this is just, this is ridiculous. You just can't have a mayor addicted to sexting.
It shows a lack of judgment is what it is. And if you want to be a politician, you know, you can't show these lapses in judgment like this. Who cares what he does? I mean, more power to him. You want to fucking sext, send pictures, jack off.
Right.
Whatever, you're a dude. But again, if you want to be a politician, you don't have those freedoms anymore to where you can do this and leave unscathed.
And he...
Now, a shock jock, on the other hand.
Right.
You can do this all you want.
And he just doesn't understand how the world works these days. You know,
Jimmy.
Which one do you like, Jimmy?
I don't like this one. You may want to be wet. He's huge for you today.
He's huge.
He's a hack.
He's a
sexting hack.
The extreme.
He's a sexting hack.
Oh,
so I guess to bring everyone up to speed, Anthony Weiner, who Well, we were the ones that officially sent the picture of Warren out there.
Yeah. Ruined him is the word you're looking for.
I think that was 2 years ago, right?
Yeah.
2 years ago.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, the picture was going to get out there, so
yeah.
I sleep well at night. It was just a matter of time. We just happened to be the ones that went for it. And then he went away, and then he comes back, and he's doing pretty good in the polls as far as becoming the next mayor of New York City. He's doing all right. People are accepting him and accepting, you know, his past is his past. And then this shit hits yesterday.
Yeah.
And the New York Times and pretty much every paper is basically saying, get the fuck out of the race.
Uh-huh.
You creep. That's what they want to write on the cover. You creep. Meet Carlos Danger is on the front page of one of our papers today.
Yes.
Oh, he's
it
terrible.
It is the worst fucking name he picked.
The Daily News. Enough of all the lies and salacious revelations. Wiener is not fit to lead America's premier city. Beat it.
Beat it. Get it? It's a jerk-off joke.
He had this one. This is how dumb this guy is. He didn't realize he was being set up. He says, so you won't tell me what picture of me you like the most or turns you on the most? Only TV? And she says, specifically your healthcare rants were a huge turn on.
Oh my God. He fell for
what
that.
A dummy.
Oh, no.
He like, fell for that shit?
Oh, my God.
He should have said, like, what are you talking about?
Right. So there was a press conference yesterday. Should we play the press conference? Should we start there, maybe?
A little bit. Oh, yeah, I think we should hear some of this.
All of a sudden, there was a press conference, and then we got all the sexting.
His wife having to stand there.
It's like 10 pages.
Having to stand there
with the
again.
Juicy ones highlighted.
Oh, yeah.
6 months after, he is finished, man.
Yeah, there's no way you come back from this, right?
No.
Man,
people never believe you again.
They gave you a chance, too, man.
That
holy
fucking
fuck.
Behind closed doors, that wife has got to be you fucking idiot.
She's going to leave him.
You had a chance, and you fucked this up. Because you,
huh?
And she's in politics.
The wife's in politics. So the wife is like, okay, I'm going to attach myself to this.
Yeah.
Like, it's not just a marriage. It's also a career move for her. Now he's gone and fucked everything up.
Right.
What kind of politics does she do?
She used to be like an aide for Hillary Clinton.
Oh, right.
Yep. Like, she was like a real...
Right. What, she was like a secretary or something?
I don't know, some kind of aide.
Did some fucking filing for Hillary? Yeah.
But she thought she would have a political career, too.
Well, some guy's got
these
a
politicians.
Inside the plane.
These politicians seem to be... Which one is that?
That's inside the fucking...
San Francisco?
No,
or LaGuardia?
LaGuardia.
Ah.
Yeah.
That was a piece of cake. I want to see inside the plane crash-landed in San Francisco. Politicians are creepy.
Yeah.
I think they're creepier than radio people.
Yeah.
It's the power
thing. I really believe that.
Yeah, it's power
absolutely,
thing.
Dude. Absolutely.
There's a million of these guys.
Yeah. Power thing.
Yep. Power thing. Everything.
I mean,
Carlos Danger has a power thing.
He does. Carlos Danger.
How humiliating.
It is humiliating.
Why would you fucking come up with a name like Carlos Danger? Jesus. I can't even look at him.
God, I would hit that so hard, your pussy would beg for mercy. Mercy. Mercy.
Well, let's go to the press conference. So, breaking news, it says, Anthony Weiner news conference on new sexting scandal. And like I said, I thought this was like some old shit that came up.
Oh, no.
But no.
Oh, no.
Here is live, Anthony Weiner.
He's at the podium. Give us a couple seconds.
His wife's smiling.
Smiling. See how degraded she feels?
That's not so bad for her, yeah.
Look at the big smile.
Yes.
The heads poking up from the cubicle behind him are the funniest part.
Mayor of the city of New York.
Like, what?
I have said that other texts and photos were likely to come out, and today they have. as I've said in the past, these things that I did were wrong and hurtful to my wife and caused us to go through many challenges in our marriage that extended past my resignation from Congress. While some of the things that have been posted today are true and some are not, there is no question that what I did was wrong. This behavior is behind me. I've apologized to my wife, Huma, and I'm grateful that she has worked through these issues.
What's going on? Hold on.
He's Carlos the Jerko.
The Jerko.
Oh, my God.
He loves jacking off.
He's fucking finished.
This guy is a complete joke.
Wow.
Why is he downplaying in this news conference? Like,
he's leaving.
But he's leaving out the fact that this new one came after he left Congress.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
He said, which went beyond my resignation. So he tried to hint at it right there.
Was this a year after, though, that's saying?
Well, I think so.
Yeah, this was last August, I think it was. Yeah.
July.
A year.
July. Yeah, a year.
Yeah, last July.
Maybe he thought after he left Congress.
He had nothing to lose. He's
like,
fuck
it. So I just don't sex.
Right. Might as well continue sexting. I have nothing to lose. I lost my gig.
Right. It was one or the other.
And he has nothing else to do. He's probably bored.
And then all of a sudden, like,
the work.
All of a sudden, he starts realizing, oh my God, I could actually make a comeback. Oh, shit. Did some things. Oh,
well, that stuff probably won't come up.
Oh, fuck. I hope they don't come up.
Your rant on healthcare got me wet.
What an idiot this guy is.
Well, you should have went, huh? What?
Right. But he's an egomaniac. Yeah. He assumed that, you know, people really enjoyed his healthcare rants.
Whose pussy got wet hearing him yell about healthcare?
Oh.
Is that a sexy subject? Oh, your cancer rant made me come. What?
Your healthcare rant especially, she said.
Oh, my God.
He's thinking, luckily I used the name Carlos Danger, so this won't come back to me.
No one will know. Yeah.
Carlos Danger?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Tied up all the loose ends with that one.
Oh, yeah. He's smarter than we are.
Yeah.
Carlos Danger.
Carlos Danger.
Carlos.
He's an international man of mystery.
That really is.
Danger.
Anyway, let's go back to the press conference.
Her forgiveness. I want to again say how very sorry I am to anyone who has received the receiving end of these messages and the disruption that this has caused. And my wife, as I have said, my wife and I, as I've said, are moving forward together. To some degree, with 49 days left until primary day, perhaps I'm surprised that more things didn't come out sooner. I'm responsible for this behavior that led us to be in this place, but in many ways, things are not that much different than they were yesterday.
Oh, yes, they
are. The behavior that I did was problematic, to say the least, destructive, to say the most, caused many stresses and strains in my marriage, but I'm pleased and blessed that she has given me a second chance. For the past several months, I've been asking New Yorkers to also give me another chance to show them that I had a vision for the middle class and those struggling to make it, and that I wanted to move forward.
Right into her vagina.
Yeah, and then back and then move forward again.
Chapter in my life to be curious about it, and I'm going to be there and try to answer those questions as best I can. It is also perfectly understandable that all of you are doing your job, being here in these great numbers, and I'm sure it's not just because of the mayoral forum we're going to have in a few minutes. But all that being said, let me just
they
reiterate
stuck around for the mayoral forum.
To my wife, how sorry I am that I did these things, and how sorry I am to the people that got these messages for any inconvenience or
he's lying.
Of course he is.
Now, some have asked the question, where does this fit in some timeline of the continuum of the resignation? The resignation was not a point in time that was nearly as important to my wife and me as the challenges in our marriage and the challenges of the things that
I
had
God.
Done, and working through them. Some of these things happened before my resignation, some of them happened after, but the fact is that was also the time that my wife and I were working through some things in our marriage. I'm glad these things are behind us. I know that this is
not
very public thing that we had happen to us, but by no means does it change the fundamentals of my feelings here, and that is that
I like jerking off.
Want to bring my vision to the people of the city of New York. I hope they're willing to still continue to give me a second chance, and I hope
they realize chance now,
that
you dummy.
In many ways, what happened today was something that frankly had happened before, but it doesn't represent all that much that is new. And now I have a chance to do something I haven't had a chance to do.
Fuck my wife.
On the campaign yet. Uma, as you know, has been out there with me recently, Uma. And she had a few words that she wanted to say. So, my amazing wife, Uma Abedin.
Amazing wife.
Yeah. Amazing wife.
Well, she was amazing.
Jeez. Yeah, my lousy sexting wife.
Right.
My wife who writes LOL every time I write cock or fuck.
Right. My wife who's obviously a horrible lay. Jesus.
But you know what? In a weird way, this is what we get. The people like the apology. It's been proven to work. He should be humiliated to say this.
Oh, my God. He should be in hiding.
But, well, this was early yesterday, so, I mean, yeah, look at the papers. He's humiliated.
I think he's surprised it made the front page. He was hoping to get buried.
I didn't hear what Uma had to say. What did Uma?
Hi, good evening.
She's smiling.
As many of you who have followed this campaign know, I've spent a good deal out on the campaign trail. At churches and street fairs.
She doesn't know
parades,
what to say.
Mention more things.
Yeah. So this is the first time I've spoken at a press conference, and you'll have to bear with me because I'm very nervous. And I wrote down what I wanted to say.
Look at Anthony Weiner laughing. I jerk off.
When we faced this publicly 2 years ago, it was the beginning of a time in our marriage that was very difficult. And it took us a very long time to get through it. Our marriage, like many others, has
like
had its
many
ups
others.
And its downs.
You know, we all like being with our husband that jerks off.
And a whole lot of therapy to get to a place where I could forgive Anthony. It was not an easy choice in any way.
Oh.
But I made the decision that it was worth staying in this
marriage. She's empowered. I made the decision.
That was a decision I made for me, for our son, and for our family. I didn't know how it would work out, but I did know that I wanted to give it a try. Anthony's made some horrible mistakes.
Oh.
Both before he resigned from Congress and after. But I do very strongly believe that that is between us in our marriage.
Well, not anymore. In every paper.
We discussed all of this before Anthony decided he would run for mayor. So really what I want to say is I love him. I have forgiven him. I believe in him.
Oh.
And as we have said from the beginning, we are moving forward. Thank you very much. Thank you for
your
time. Oh, boy. She is beautiful, man. She's really fucking hot.
Yes. Now what happens? Does he take questions?
Yeah.
Oh,
No prank questions got through, unfortunately.
But do they ask about this?
Yeah. Yeah, would be the topic of conversation.
Well, how would you best relieve the traffic problems in our fair city?
Mr. Danger! Mr. Danger!
Mr. Danger! Danger.
Candidate Danger!
Yes! Oh, God. Candidate Danger. Yes. Carlos.
And he responds to it. Candidate Danger. Yes.
Danger. Carlos Danger. Danger.
Oh, my God.
Look at that name.
This is so ridiculous. All right, let's. You want to hear him answer a few questions about
it? I certainly do.
Okay.
I have to take one or two questions.
One or two.
Did your wife find out that there were messages after the resignation?
Oh. She knew all along.
No, she didn't.
This process, as I was more and more honest with her.
As I was more and more. Could you pause that? Is so telling. He goes, she was aware of this all along, and then realized, no, not all along. The process, and then as we worked through this, and I became more and more honest with her. No, as she dug up more shit and you had to fucking fess up to it.
I should continue to go, what the fuck is this?
You don't become more and more honest. You become less and less deceptive because you're caught.
Mm-hmm. You know, a year in. A year after the scandal, she must have said, are you still fucking doing this?
Yeah, yeah, right. Exactly.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Yeah.
It's like, oh, we talked about that. No, yeah, honey, of course I'm still doing this. What?
Oh, I thought when...
Yeah. Oh. I thought with her you didn't want me to do it.
Right.
Oh,
right.
Oh, you mean with anybody? Oh, see.
I thought... I thought if I changed my name...
Yes.
Oh.
Honey, I thought you knew that's why I resigned. Yeah. I thought we talked about that.
That I could still do this. See, we need to communicate better.
Right. Obviously, there's a communication problem here.
Yes.
This is pretty much just, this is just as much on you as it is on me, right? Frankly.
See, Anthony Weiner stopped.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But Carlos Danger.
Carlos Danger still needs to. Ah, there's some coming in. Carlos Danger in your ass only. A view of my cock. brown finger.
brown finger.
He's the man. The man with the smelly touch. Oh, man.
More and more honest.
This guy's a clown. He's a clown.
He is a clown.
He just is trying to look for loopholes where he could still jerk off.
Yeah.
He's just a clown. Well, I'm going to hear him answer a few questions.
Thunderballs.
This is something we knew going into the decision about whether I would run. What is that question?
Is this over? Are you in touch with any women right now? No,
this is entirely behind me. It was when I decided to get in and we had this conversation. That is why, if you remember, in the early days of the campaign, people were pressing me for, is there more out there? And I said, yes. I said that there was. And so...
But when were they made?
That's the biggie.
We didn't ask when.
Yeah.
See,
you asked. I said there might be more out there.
Mm.
I didn't say it might be from last week.
I got a question.
Uh-huh.
Anthony Weiner worse than Bobo for falling for online scams?
Oh, no.
I just want to throw that out there.
Oh,
question.
No.
That's a question today.
They'll write up Carlos Danger, right? Why can't I be Carlos Danger? This girl likes me. She liked my speech. Let's go to the Mets game. I'm Carlos Danger, right? With my sidekick, Mr. Balloonigans. He's a schdoodle.
Man,
oh, my God.
This is why satellite radio was invented, because we get to read these things uncensored in a minute or two.
That's the only way. God,
but first, wonderful. More of the press conference.
Oh.
Just acknowledged that we knew might come up, and we decided that, look, this was something that we had worked through together, something I put behind us, and something we wanted to keep behind us. But as I've said, it's in our rearview mirror, but it's not far. We still work every day at our
mind.
How do you explain that? Yeah, I mean, this is, I said there were more things out there. You have as a fixed time the resignation as the important moment in the public discussion. That was
Pause.
When the public got a glimpse.
And what is he, a time traveler? Someone has to say this. When he said there's more out there, it was around the time he was stepping down.
Yeah.
So everyone could accept that part of it.
Right.
But he did it after that. That's the problem everyone has here.
14 months later.
He's time traveling there, trying to say the stuff I did after I resigned is what I kind of told you was, you know, it was a possibility, it was out there. What is he talking about?
He said it again after, I think, that when he came back, I think he said, oh, there's more out. I think he said it again when he came back.
This is the problem. You don't need... just play it. I was trying to figure out... this timeline.
Because
he said initially, he's trying
to be clever and vague. Yes, where, yes. Where, look, I told you there was more out there, but he didn't really.
He initially said there's going to be more of this.
Right.
There's more out there.
Right.
And then when he ran for mayor, he said, now remember, there's more out there. But he had made more in between those two.
Right, he made more is the problem. Yeah, Thank you. That's a better way to put it.
He made more.
But he's trying to say, no, there's more out there.
It's that residual stuff.
Right. Residual, right. He wants people to kind of think it was residual. That old thing. Holy fuck, I hate this. I don't like this guy.
Yeah, he's a real arrogant scumbag. He is an arrogant scumbag. Yeah, because he thinks he's smart. He thinks he's smarter than everybody else.
Yeah, that's what it is, Jimmy. No one's perfect. I mean, please. But there's something about this guy that's really hateable now.
Mm-hmm. I don't care about his sex thing. It's this shit that I hate him for.
Right. His arrogance about it.
Yeah, Carlos Danger, I get.
Yeah, yeah. Just can't get fucking...
That's the part that I'm totally fine with.
Cunt.
Who knows what his wife is like? Maybe she's a lame fucking texter. Maybe he tries to be dirty with her and she gives him nothing. Hillary doesn't. I'm doing it because you have Hillary. I'm shaving down her cankles.
Oh, God.
Just to shave Hillary's cankles with a fucking razor.
What a great job to have.
Into something that we had been working on before, during, and since. And this behavior of mine was part of that. And when we went through this process and we became closer and worked through some of these challenges. We put it behind us, and I put it behind me. And frankly, we're in a lot better place today, or else I would not have run for mayor. I can't say exactly.
Yes, you can.
Sometime last summer, I think.
Was it after you told People Magazine quote, or your wife told People Magazine?
Wait, what was the answer? What was the question?
When was the last one you sent? I think he's like, I can't say. Sometime last summer, I think.
No, yeah. Which is not true.
Of course it's not.
What a fucking asshole.
How could it be?
What do you mean, I think? You would know at this point.
When was the last time? Right, probably about 2 weeks before the scandal broke. That would have been the acceptable answer.
Uh-huh. He goes, he throws I think in there because he knows that there's more. Yeah, and he's just praying that they don't pop up either.
I think.
You can't just throw I think in. You would know specifically when it ended, if it ended at all.
Yeah, when did you start getting the shakes from not fucking sexting?
Oh, man.
He loves it. Oh, boy, does he love talking about his cock.
He's addicted. Yeah. Period.
Dick.
I completely understand this guy. I get it. It's like, I mean, so many people do. It's not hard to understand how you get caught in this.
I just can't then run for mayor.
Yeah,
sorry.
Just admit that, look, maybe it's
but
not
Jimmy,
the right
you
time.
Nailed it. It's the arrogance about the whole fucking thing. You're right.
Yeah.
You're right.
He's standing up there like we're all dumb. Like,
right. Like, he's almost annoyed he has to do his press conference. Look, I told you there might be more out there.
Yeah, I thought I explained myself.
He throws an I think out
there. What are all these questions for?
Right.
I spelled everything out perfectly for everybody here.
Do you think Spitzer's happy about this, though? Because it takes the heat off him. Like, hey, I stopped.
We got two guys.
No more whores in my fucking past.
Find another prostitute.
Yeah,
find
go
one.
Ahead. I dare you.
Oh, but you know, he's jonesing. Behind closed doors, he shakes himself to sleep every night, jonesing about it.
He's just jerking off to pics of that girl in the New York Post.
Right? Oh, yeah, Ashley Dupree.
Yeah, he loves her.
I bet his wife was really cunty this week, too. As soon as Wiener's thing, I bet his wife was, so what have you been up to? Nothing.
Nothing. Yeah.
She's been a cunt on wheels all week.
Imagine that. It's Ray Mancini on Fox.
Huh?
Ray Mancini there on Fox.
He gave us a great interview yesterday.
He's terrific.
Totally wonderful. I hope he comes back.
The wife, Spitzer's wife.
Sylvia or Sylvia.
Yeah.
Silda.
Oh.
Silda.
See? You want this to happen to you? He's like, I didn't even do anything. This fucking wiener has to do this shit. And now the wife gets on me?
And people don't pay close attention. A lot of people do, but there's a whole...
That think that
they probably are thinking this is a Spitzer thing that popped up again. Yeah. You know,
you hear what Spitzer did,
right?
Spitzer's like, no,
not me. It's the other
me.
It's
the other prostitute guy,
right? Not the sexting guy.
Not the sexting.
Spitzer's commercials come on. I can't believe they're letting him run out. Just saw him on the news talking about sexting.
His poor wife.
No.
Let's
no.
go back to this arrogant asshole.
Oh, yeah.
Jimmy nailed it. That's what the problem is here.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Yes. Your mom calls you to drop out of the race. What do you say to those people who want you to drop out of the race?
I'm sure many of my opponents would like me to drop out of the race.
That isn't an answer.
When was the definitive moment here for you? You said some things were true online, some things weren't true. Can you tell us what was not true?
No, I think I said in my statement one of the things I'm
no,
not
No, I can't
going
say it's not true, because there's nothing that's not true.
Yeah, and I'm not sure what else is going to surface, so
yes.
Let it all surface, and then we'll try to figure it out.
Go ahead and ask a couple questions. I won't answer them, but yeah, you can go ahead and ask away.
Yeah, ask away. I'm not going to say shit.
Later he'll say, I let you ask your questions.
Yes. I came up here of my own free will.
And instead of... When they said, like, what do you say to your opponents who want you to drop out of the race? He basically goes, well, I'm awesome, so of course they want me to drop
out.
Yeah.
Instead I'm sure plenty of my opponents want me to drop out. No, we didn't ask you that.
Yeah.
We asked, what do you say to the people that want you to drop out?
I rule.
I am fucking amazing.
Challenges behind us. Challenges.
Me and my wife face these challenges. They're behind us now from... 2 days ago.
Yes. By behind us, I mean my phone's in my back pocket. Oh, Anthony.
That would be great if you just heard bling, his fucking texts going off in his pocket. He's like, oh, shit.
All right, let's get to the end of this press conference from yesterday.
And I said it to your newspaper, as I'm not going to get into a back and forth with people who are releasing things, whether they be true or not. People have a right to say
deniability
they want,
of everything.
I brought that upon myself. I'm prepared not to dispute anything that is out there, but suffice it to say that people are out there saying things that are not true.
But what else is out there?
But that's not the point.
What else is out there?
Could we hear that fucking poignant shouted question?
That's great.
I studied body language a little bit. This guy is looking down. This guy is a lying piece of shit.
You think so?
Yes. That's a huge tell when you can't look at the person asking you a question. When you start looking down like that, that's a basic one, to be honest with you. That's just basic body language shit.
Do you think he's wishing this didn't happen?
Well, sure. But fucking just go away.
Yeah.
Go do something else.
Write a book.
Whatever.
Anthony Weiner, I love jerking off.
I love jerking off.
There's obviously a lot of stuff out there.
Could you hear that question? How that was shout? That was so perfectly timed and shouted. Right. What else is out there?
And he's like, geez, oh boy.
But suffice it to say that people are out there saying things that are not true. But
what else is out there?
But that's not the point. That's not the point. I accept the responsibility for having these conversations with these people who I never met, with exchanging inappropriate things in the context of our marriage, and that was a mistake, and I bear responsibility.
So he's looking up again.
That is behind me, and we're trying to move forward, and we are recognize it's not going to be easy.
You better recognize.
We knew the moment we got into this race that it wasn't going to be easy, but I believe this is an important thing to be doing. Thank you all very much.
I'm going to go in the back now and get screamed at again.
Yeah. Oh, man. You fucking owe me big time.
You condescending cocksucker.
Yeah.
Yeah, I bet you she leaves him. This
after,
is just...
fucking resigned. You did this.
She's in that world, man. Who knows?
She'll let this play out, and then she'll fuck it. Although Hillary stay with Bill. Sometimes that's why it's hard to feel bad for these political wives, because they stick around because that's the fucking... They signed up for this.
It's a power thing.
Yeah.
It helps their career. But what kind of career does she really have? She does filing or something?
I think she's trying to build one.
Yeah. Build one.
And she just got onto the wrong horse.
Good luck.
Did she? Oh, my God.
So, man, Danger 33, I guess, huh? D-A-N-G-R 33.
Nice.
We should just read all of them. Fuck us.
They are quite amazing.
3, 4, 5. This is like 10 pages.
Oh, there's some good ones.
You guys should act them out.
Fuck yeah.
Not you, Chip.
Should we use one of our interns?
Oh, Jesus.
God, yes.
I don't know if we can.
It's a Why news not? Story.
It's a fucking bitch to read on the air.
We need a female voice, to be honest with you.
Where's Jack Hay?
Where's Sydney? See who wants to do this. Her or Sydney?
Where's Jackie Blue?
Hello, Sydney. And Jack Kay.
Jack Kay.
We need a female voice.
Otherwise, it doesn't sound.
Yeah.
And they're really sexy male voice. From in that studio in there.
Jack.
What kind of
sexy male? Can you read some sexing shit for us?
Sure.
You could say no.
No, that's fine.
Because I don't know where the line is with this shit. It's on air, but.
How many summery sundresses do you have?
Here, probably only like 5 or 6.
Really?
Yeah. This one has pockets, though.
Oh, cool.
So it's awesome.
It's awesome. It's cool.
What dress has pockets in it?
Yeah.
If any other intern ever came in and told Anthony, look, I have pockets, do you think his response would be, oh, cool?
No.
What?
I'm,
you don't like pockets?
I turn into Anthony Weiner when the intern's around. I can't help it.
Sam's a communist. You don't like pockets?
I don't mind pockets. I have pockets. Hey, Ann, I have pockets in my pants.
No one cares.
Absolutely.
All right, show Jackie her
pocketage.
You could say no to this shit.
No, it's not.
Jackie, you're gonna read here. I'll hold it for you. You're gonna read the parts that are
highlighted.
No,
that's
underneath.
Yeah,
the part that'd be highlighted, be like girls I've talked to.
Hi, Daddy.
You're underneath for this reading.
Do I start?
No.
Of course not.
Yell.
No, of course not.
Don't yell at the little
trying
deer.
Trying to understand her lines
the
here.
The little deer is trying to understand.
She's doing us a favor here.
You know, you guys are right. You're absolutely right, and I apologize.
So who's gonna?
What are they?
What the fuck?
I'm sorry.
Fox and Friends, they're lifting weights on the sidewalk.
They're
what are they
outside
doing today?
On the sidewalk.
Why aren't they talking about Anthony Weiner?
Kettlebells.
Wouldn't you blow off everything and just talk about Anthony Weiner?
All day.
They're doing a
kettlebell workout.
When I worked out on the sidewalk.
When I was walking in outside the Fox building, they were miking up a guy dressed up as a Revolutionary War
Yeah, I thought he was looking like a English guy, baby, for the royal baby.
Maybe that's what it was.
I passed him by because my truck, I stop at a light right there when I'm coming in, and I just pray for the day they flip the camera on while I'm there because I will ruin them. I will roll that window down and say stuff.
But you're a gatekeeper for Fox. You can't do that.
I'm in the inner circle.
You can't do that. It's going to ruin it. All right, let's get into this. So Anthony Weiner as Carlos Danger.
Well, who's playing Carlos Danger?
Who is going to play Carlos Danger?
It could be E-Rock. It could be Chip. It could be anybody in the studio that you think is appropriate. Mm.
I don't even know if it needs to be a Chip because it's so good. As
well, Jim
fucking
won't do it. Because the gym will enjoy it too much.
shit.
You rock?
No, I'm good, thanks.
Oh.
Yeah, I don't know if I want to play the part either. Who wants to play the part of Carlos Danger? I'm trying to think how this would work. Kenny.
Or Sal.
Kenny, right?
Oh, God.
Kenny's a married man, and he might have to hear a lot of flack about it. Uh-huh. He may not want to do it.
Mm-hmm. We could ask him.
GH, I'm celebrating 25 wonderful years. I don't talk that way.
Shit.
Kenny, would you play Carlos Danger?
Carlos Dulger.
He's putting on his reading glasses, so he might be in.
I'm an entertainer. It has nothing to do with my personal
life. Oh, shit. Good for Kenny. I mean, Carlos Danger.
Mm-hmm.
Do you need a script?
Yeah.
Yeah. So playing the part of Carlos Danger, which obviously is the alias for Anthony Weiner.
Yes.
Will be Club Soda Kenny.
Oh, into the Mark's Mike CD.
And what do we know about the gal? Where's she from? How
She's
old
from
is
Chicago.
She?
From Chicago. He was kind of promising her a condo. She's 22. I don't know how he met her. Probably online, Facebook or whatever.
Well, she's pretty hot.
Yeah, she's pretty. I'm happy that they showed her real face, though, because if you're going to out public figures like this, fuck you. You don't deserve privacy.
Well, it was a website that figured it out. It wasn't like the news going, oh, let's just.
Well, she's in the paper, though.
Yeah.
Oh, BuzzFeed got her. Okay.
Wait, how did this come about?
I don't know. I'm not sure. I know BuzzFeed, they're saying the ones who showed her picture, probably because they support Weiner.
Yeah.
But I don't know how these came out.
But how did they get together?
Who, her and him? Oh, I don't know. Probably Facebook, I think.
Oh.
So what, he had a fake Facebook page?
Probably a real one.
Holy fuck.
Oh, man.
Yeah, where did Carlos Danger... It'll all come out where Carlos Danger...
Wait, we don't know yet, though?
Do we? I don't know.
Heard where it came from.
All I know is I did Red Eye the other night, and one of the people I did Red Eye with was that the actress... oh, God, what the fuck? She was very nice.
You took a picture with her.
Yeah. We hold on. I'm saying this for a reason.
Mm-hmm.
No, it's not her. Cocksucker.
Cocksucker?
No. Oh. That's who she was talking to.
Oh, okay. I can't believe nobody on here is fucking popping it up.
Mm.
You fucking
Barrett. Guys. Barrett Swatek. Well. She's on MTV. So I got a text from her last night.
Oh.
We missed Carlos Danger by one fucking day.
Yeah.
Right.
And I'm like, who is that?
Oh,
I didn't know
no.
who it was. She wrote my dad. And,
I'm
like, and then hours later, I saw Travis's news thing. I'm like, holy fuck.
Unbelievable.
We missed it by a day.
Now, people are suggesting that we bring in good old Denny for the Carlos Danger part.
He would never read it.
He doesn't work. He would. He's a professional.
He doesn't work blue. You weren't here the day he refused to...
He doesn't even curse.
Nope.
But to read something like this, a news story on satellite radio, Denny might.
I'm betting he will not do it.
I'm with that.
I'm betting he will not do it.
I don't think you were here the day that he basically told us he doesn't work blue.
Oh, I do. I remember that.
Were you here?
Yeah, I remember hating him for that.
Oh, you were here. That's right.
Yes,
I stared to my right and fought the urge to bite him.
Now they
just bite his elbows.
Now they're just lifting weights on the sidewalk. What's wrong with Fox and Friends?
Yeah, wow.
They got a huge audience, though.
You see that jumping up there in the back on those boxes? That is a motherfucker. Just that jumping up and down sucks.
Mm-hmm.
I hate jumping.
Oh, she's pretty cute right
now. Oh, she's a delight. Squatting.
We got eggs, too. Should we take a break and figure out the whole reading of this?
I see Denny shaking his head. Like, no.
Oh, really?
He's like, no.
He has a head like Wiener. His head is shaped like Anthony Wiener.
There he is.
Oh, that's right.
Oh, yeah. He's got entrance music. How you doing, Denny?
Hi, Denny.
Hello.
We might need you.
Okay.
In a couple of minutes, we're going to need you to read something.
Fine.
Cool.
You would read Carlos Danger?
Whatever you need.
Wow.
Yeah, Denny's a professional.
What happened? I thought you don't work blue.
Well, as long as there's no blue language in there.
Okay, well, you can just work around it.
Will you say come?
Sure.
As a beverage.
No, I would say it as a song title, like Come to Me by Fran Jolie. Great disco hit from 1979.
Oh, God.
What other come songs do you know?
What's that?
What other come songs?
Come Baby Come by K7, good dance record.
Mm-hmm.
Good song. Come Baby Come. That's a good dance
record. Come on, Eileen.
Very good.
Well, you know what that means, though, right?
What's that?
You know what that means, right?
Come on, Eileen.
I guess it would.
Kenny, why don't we do this? Do you want to let Denny start and just see how far he can go with it? Like, Kenny, can you let him do it just and you're the reserve, just in case Denny is not as effective? And Denny, you want to just use Kenny's mic so young Jackie can read her part? And,
sure.
Don't go far, Kenny.
This is all for the good of the show, right?
Absolutely. It's all for the show.
Yes, Denny.
You're the yellow highlighted part. You're Carlos, and Jackie is playing the other gal.
Carlos Danger, who is Anthony Weiner.
Okay.
Yes. So you start off, Denny.
I must have come thinking about you and looking at you 100 times. How does that make you feel? Gross?
That turns me on so much. Seriously.
I said it was hard. Help me.
Almost home. Be patient.
So I walk into a hotel room and there you are at the end of the bed, naked except for some amazing beep beep shoes.
Beep beep shoes.
That's my favorite line.
Your legs are spread. Your feet are flat on the ground. You're leaning slightly forward, looking completely in charge, by golly.
You know, we could always make that fantasy a reality.
Do you want me to continue? Because it's not highlighted here.
It's not highlighted.
Yes, highlighted here.
It's just the best.
Yeah, that was just to kind of let you know what part you are. Beep beep shoes.
Beep beep shoes.
Of course, the word was fuck me shoes.
Ah,
Denny. Yeah, continue. Even though
it's
not highlighted.
You gotta read it, Denny. It's part of. This is a news story.
And what do I get?
We'll see.
Can I tell you what I thought about last night that made me come?
Please do.
Still holding your hair, I spread your legs. Your beep beeps are swinging already as you wiggle. I take out my beep and I lean over and whisper, "What do you want me to do to you?"
Yuck.
That's just awful.
That's horrible.
Benny, it's satellite radio.
What's a beepy?
Yeah, but I don't work Blue.
This is an extreme channel.
We're not working Blue. This is a news story.
This is a news story. This is like legitimate news. This is what the mayoral candidate said.
News channels do, they don't say those words.
Oh.
Yeah, they would beep them out.
On satellite, they wouldn't.
No, we can't. What do we have?
I don't know if
Fox,
I want the beep beep.
News
no, beep beep is awful.
I hate beep beep.
I do too. So she's the Roadrunner's trying to fuck her. It's terrible.
Beep, beep. I think Danny failed us today.
That might be funny. Well, I don't work Blue. You know that. Coming in here, you know that.
Well,
coming in here, you know that.
Coming in here. Come on now.
Well, I hope Kenny was fucking just hanging by. We might need Kenny.
Yeah.
I think Kenny is better suited for this role.
Yeah.
But this was your big opportunity.
Yeah, Danny, you really did.
I'm happy with my other opportunities that you've given me, and I thank you every day for that.
What other cum songs do you know?
Let me see.
Got to go with Come Together, obviously. Oh, that's probably the number one cum song of
probably.
All time.
Sure. Yeah. Let me see. Yeah. Let me see. Come a little bit closer. Jay and the Americans.
Jay and the Americans.
Yeah, come see about me. Diana Ross of the Supremes.
Mm-hmm.
I believe we've covered the amount of.
No, I'm sure there's quite a few more.
I'm sure.
Come as you are.
Yes, very good. Nirvana.
Oh, right.
Nirvana.
Very good.
Came on my leg. Jim Norton.
The artist. Jim Norton.
I'll have to dig those up on the hard drive of hits.
Ah, yes.
All right, Danny, you failed us.
Thank you.
I'm sorry.
No, beep, that was beep. Terrific.
You guys have a great time in Canada.
You got your standards. We're flying today to Montreal, Canada.
Very nice.
For a couple days.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Crank up some Guess Who on the way, right? A little Guess Who. Canadian rock and roll. Brian Adams.
Yes, I'm going to watch Family Ties.
Anne Murray, the Canadian songbird.
Oh,
you are a beephead.
You really are.
The Canadian songbird.
Oh, you suck a bag of beeps.
You like the Canadian songbird?
I love Anne Murray.
What was Anne Murray's big song?
No one loves Anne Murray.
Snowbird, You Needed Me. Can I have this dance?
Everything I want the world to be is coming through for it. Right.
Very nice.
You need it.
Not a cloud in the sky. Got my ass in.
And Could I Have This Dance? 1980 hit music. A big song popularized in the movie Urban Cowboy. A lot of people use that as a first dance. Just in case you're looking for first dance suggestions.
No, we're not. We'd like a little Anne Murray, though, an hour into the bit.
I didn't hear the song title.
Oh, no. Where were you?
Anthony was singing.
Where were you?
Snowbird.
Yeah, and You Needed Me.
You Needed Me. Could I Have This Dance?
Yeah.
What's he doing?
Asking?
Oh, I don't know.
Where's E-Rock? Is he in there?
Oh, no.
Oh, Danny.
I couldn't see him. No. I couldn't see him through the glass on the glare on the glass. That's all.
It's impossible.
All right, Danny. I guess we're not. Oh.
There we go. A little snowbird.
Timing's everything.
All right. Even though we try to chill things up in this heat wave of the summertime, what happened to the music? Sort of dropped out. But Anne Murray steps up to the mic and
has a no, back.
The Canadian songbird.
It sounds very Glenn Campbell.
I'll give you that, yeah.
It's like Gentle on My Mind.
Very nice. Good song. I used to love a Glenn Campbell show.
Oh, who didn't?
Hi, I'm Glenn Campbell. It's knowing that your door is open. Yeah.
Now it's, hey, you're Glenn Campbell. Really?
Yeah. Who? What?
Wichita Lineman by the time I get to Phoenix.
Ah, yes.
Remember Phonics, that reading program?
Hooked on Phonics worked for me.
By the time I get to Phonics, I'll be reading. We used to say that when we used to do the commercials.
Holy shit.
Yeah, how about that one?
How about it?
That was a good one.
How about
Southern,
that?
You also had Southern Nights.
Southern Nights. Meow. Yep, and he got Rhinestone Cowboy, which was a huge hit.
Very good, very good.
That was a good one.
Oh, like a rhinestone cowboy.
Well, we got to go to break, Danny. Thank you.
All right, guys. Well, thank you very much
for having standards, I guess.
Yeah. Always good seeing you.
Sarah from Buffalo on Twitter. Beep, beep, shoes. Maybe one of the greatest lines I've ever heard. After the break, Jackie and Kenny will be reading the Anthony Weiner / Carlos Danger sexting text messages, right?
Yeah.
All right.
Right.
SiriusXM. This is the Opie and Anthony Show.
Happy birthday, J-Lo. 44.
This is on my iPod.
No, I know. I remember. We did a whole bit on it.
Why not is the question.
Jimmy likes this one.
Delightful song.
Jackie likes it. She's dancing. She's chair dancing.
Yeah. She's Jenny. She's the same.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah. She hasn't changed.
Yeah. She loves her life in her public.
Right. You don't like the J-Lo.
Jenny from the block, indeed. I don't believe
she'll always be Jenny from the block.
I don't believe that she's Jenny from the block.
She may have some rocks, but don't allow them to fool you.
Yeah, she's got everything, but she's still Jenny from the block.
Yes.
Weena sent me pictures of his cock. I'm still Jenny from the block.
Weena sent me pictures.
Good old Weena. All right, we should get into the sex thing.
Yeah.
Anthony Weiner as Carlos Danger.
Ah.
Yeah.
Danger.
I'm going to start from the top because Denny did a horrendous job reading this.
It's just terrible.
Because he doesn't work blue.
No, so you're saying beep when the bad language was there.
Her beep beep shoes.
Her beep beep shoes.
Her beeps were swinging.
Right.
Were they?
What does that mean?
I don't know.
But he was saying cum every other word.
Yeah.
And it's spelled C-U-M, so he was saying it in the term that it's meant to be.
Sure. He doesn't understand.
No, he doesn't know anything.
He's got his hard drive of hits. It's all like,
they misspelled cum here.
All right, so here we go. This is the conversation he had with a young lady, Anthony Weiner as Carlos Danger.
We start
young lady from Chicago.
Yes. With Anthony Weiner's part.
Yes, played by Kenny.
Club Soda Kenny.
Oh,
Club Soda Kenny.
The entertainer.
On Facebook.
Right. On Kenny. Facebook, it's Club Soda Kenny.
I must have come thinking about you and looking at you 100 times. How does that make you feel? Gross?
That turns me on so much. Seriously.
I said I was hard. Help me.
Almost home. Be patient.
So I walk into a hotel room, and you were at the end of the bed naked, except for some amazing fuck-me shoes. Your legs are spread, your feet are flat on the ground, and you are leaning slightly forward, looking completely in charge.
You know, we could always make that fantasy a reality.
No. Yeah, keep reading.
Even you don't want me just to...
No.
Just
so we have the whole conversation.
Okay. Yeah. And what do I get?
We'll see.
Can I tell you what I thought about last night that made me come?
Please do.
Beating a skull's head in.
Yeah. If it's some purple wood shampoo.
Putting shoe leather on a guy's teeth.
This is the worst reading ever.
He's yelling it. It's menacing.
And then Jackie's really got that Rochester accent.
I will say, I give Jackie's rendition of, out of 10, I give it a fucking 9.5 out of 10. Phenomenal rendition.
She's all in.
Yeah.
It's just the accent that's a little strange.
Yeah. We'll say she was from Rochester instead of Chicago.
All right.
Yeah. No, that's right. The difference.
It's like the same
similar accent,
anyway.
Actually.
You know, she's probably
pretty close.
Hey, come on home over there. Be careful.
Yeah.
Careful.
I want you to fuck me like Dennis Farina.
Just a little nasally.
Yeah.
But the Rochester gals have that.
Oh, I'm all wet down there like a deep dish pizza.
All right, page two. Here we go.
I slide my
car. Where are you?
Oh.
Well, look at the date.
Yeah, it says one, two, three, four.
Oh.
Going up.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
Give me your bratwurst.
All right, I'm sorry, Kenny.
Yeah, go ahead, Kenny.
I slide my cock in you slow at first. You are so tight. And then harder, my balls slapping your ass. With each thrust, you squeal a little. I start to fuck you so hard, your tits almost hit you in the face.
He fucking wrote that?
How terrible.
That is awful sexting.
He's a sexting hack.
He's the worst. You know how hard you have to picture fucking somebody and their tits are smashing them in the face.
Smashing them in the face.
How unsexy that is.
Yeah.
Yeah, those are big tits.
Yeah, they're A cups. That's how hard he wants to fuck her. I want to fuck you to your A cups are hitting your forehead.
All right. You reach back and spread your ass.
I want to make this happen as soon as possible.
I walk right up to you and bend down, grab the back of your hair, and put my tongue deep in your mouth. You grab my cock, still holding your hair and still kissing you. I stand you up.
You're making me so wet. I want this to happen.
Still holding your hair, now standing, I take my other hand and finger your pussy. It's wet, soaked. I turn you around and bend you over the back of a chair. Your pussy asking for it.
Yeah, pussy.
Fuck me, baby.
Still holding your hair, I spread your legs. Your tits are swinging already as you wiggle. I take out my cock and I lean over and whisper, "What do you want me to do to you?"
Ravage me.
Would you like me to hold your hair while you're gagging on my cock?
Jesus. This guy can't be the mayor.
Absolutely.
Would you let me come on those perfect tits?
I would let you come anywhere you wanted.
Me too.
Staring me at too.
Oh, he's the worst.
Dudo.
I hear you. I want to come in you right after Master zaps me with electricity and gives me life. I want to throw a small girl down the well.
Oh, fuck.
I'm going to come on you as soon as the villagers stop chasing you with torches.
Alright, continue.
Not pathetic at all, so flattering. I think about you all the time. I can't help myself.
If I met you in a bar and tried to talk to you, would I have a chance?
Absolutely. You're such an amazing man. I still can't believe someone like you would pay attention to someone like me. It's literally a dream come true.
You are a fantasy to me. Have you made yourself come thinking about me recently?
God.
This morning.
You are a walking fantasy.
I don't want to just be a fantasy. I want to take care of your every need.
Why are you awake? What are you thinking about today? How do you look?
I don't sleep a lot. Obviously, I'm thinking about you, and I've been doing some painting today. Right now, I have no makeup on, and I'm topless.
I'm deeply flawed.
No, read the script.
That's what you say on your business card.
Club Soda Kenny, and I'm deeply flawed.
I'm deeply flawed.
We all are. Imperfection is beauty, and madness is genius.
God, I want to take you from behind in front of a mirror. I want to see your face and feel your pussy spasm as I come with me deep in you.
You have no idea how much I want this to be more than a fantasy. I've never wanted anyone as much as I want you. You're perfect.
I make me insane. More. I'm going to come again so hard.
Trying to upload a pic, but my phone is being slow. Try to be patient.
I like to whisper in your ear while I make love to you. That okay?
That okay?
I can't maintain an erection unless the Rodney King video is showing in the background.
More than okay. Just the idea of it turns me on so much. I want to connect with you on every level.
Standing behind you, lathering with one hand, fingering you with the other.
Baby, you make me so wet. I want you to slowly enter me while passionately kissing me.
Taking a shower. Want to join me?
That sounds perfect.
I wish you would have sent that text in 1942.
Oh, shit.
You may want to be wet. He's huge for you today.
Oh, he? About you this Iraq showering with him?
You always make me wet.
All of me?
Absolutely.
Wet? Put on some shoes. I would spread your ass so my cock hits deep.
Why would you put on shoes?
Why put on shoes?
Put on shoes.
I want
put
you
on some shoes. I want to fuck you while we watch Stop and Frisk in the subway. Put your dancing shoes on. And I'll wear the black ones that Master put on me.
I want you as deep inside me as you possibly can get.
What are you wearing? Much for me to take off? I'd hold you by your throat.
I'm wearing a skirt and no panties. Easy access for you.
God, I would hit that so hard. Your pussy would beg for mercy.
Much like the listener's ears are.
Much like many people I just pulled over for a traffic ticket.
I would hit your pussy like it was a billy club between my legs. I want to hit you right in the perp.
I want you to pin me over my desk right now.
Like what you see?
What?
What?
Like what you see?
Oh. So obviously... like what you see?
I'm like trying to figure out what that line was. Come on, you, I will.
He texted, like what you see, so obviously he's sending pictures during this whole time.
Like what you see?
Very much so. I was attracted to you way before all that happened. I don't know the last word.
Yeah, it's covered up by the dirty.com.
Probably all that happened before this.
Some of that, yeah.
Sure.
I found the perfect woman. Gorgeous, sexy, and a little bit of my crazy.
I basically worship the ground you walk on. You're incredible.
So you won't tell me what picture of me you would like the most or turned you on the most?
Specifically.
Wait, what's going on? You missed the last part.
Yeah, what is it? Only
TV.
Oh. I didn't understand.
Okay, read it again.
Only TV.
Yeah, that's a key word.
Yeah, read it again.
Okay. So you want me... So you won't tell me what picture of me you liked the most or turned you on the most? Only TV?
Specifically, your healthcare rants were a huge turn.
Oh, my God. Healthcare rants.
Oh, what an
those
idiot.
Those are sexy.
Sadly, my pics are out there to look at. Have you ever...
Yes, and I must say, I'm quite impressed.
Oh, Jesus.
Tell me about your pussy. Smooth?
Very.
Tell me about your pussy.
How humiliating.
Oh,
God. Jesus. And he fucking bought into it. I like your healthcare, right?
And he still went.
So he can't even deny that it's him.
Right.
Wow, what a dope.
I was reading your tweets and looking at your pics, so I thought I'd hold your wrist to settle you down.
You have no idea how turned on I am right now. I really want you to manhandle me.
Okay.
That's it, huh?
Wow.
More will come out.
That's it for now.
This is great, though. This is literally wow. Like opening up a fucking new DVD box set. You know, more episodes are right behind.
There's more. There's more.
There are not. Don't this is worry. Not the end of it.
No, they wouldn't put it all out there in one day, right? They probably would spread it out a little bit.
Now, I would like Jackie and Kenny to read a text exchange that I had recently with the young lady.
Jackie, could you make your voice a lot deeper?
Hello, buddy.
Yeah.
Yes.
Good job, Kenny.
Yeah, very good, Kenny.
Very good.
Very sexy.
Very powerful. Yeah. Yes. Kenny is very powerful.
It's amazing.
Hold your wrists. Your pussy.
Your pussy.
And, of course, the lovely Jackie.
Very good
bang
job.
Up, marvelous job.
Bang up job
marvelous,
right there.
Yes. Thank you.
That terrific. Was very good. With your little Mary Tyler Moore hat.
My dress with pockets.
Yes, and your little summery dress with pockets.
Oh, cool.
She's just adorable. There she goes. Jackie. It's gonna. What interns are we going to get next? Because we'll just stop the intern program.
We got to just get girl interns now.
Yeah.
Now that we set the precedent, Sam.
More smelly, greasy guys fucking coming
in. Travis, we got anything new?
No new wieners.
Oh, boo.
Laundry day, Travis?
Oh, yeah, the Geraldo thing.
Travel.
Travel day, okay. That's your Wobot shirt.
Yeah.
Does he say the thing that we were talking about this morning?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, good.
Yeah, that's where it came from.
Okay, good. Oh. Yeah. So, Geraldo. I guess we can move on to Geraldo. Oh, I'm sure we'll get back to Anthony Weiner.
This is all just fucking disgusting.
It's exhausting.
It really is.
So, Geraldo.
It's older people with their cell phones who don't realize the implications that it's forever.
It's forever, and it's all
ever,
everywhere.
Ever, ever.
And it goes everywhere.
So, Geraldo did the selfie over the weekend to show everyone that 70 looks good.
He said 70 is the new 50. Look out. So he was rocking it in front of the mirror with fucking barely covering his dick and balls with a towel. Everything else was showing except just his dick and
that's
balls.
That's what bothers me the most about his selfie, because he thought about the towel placement for a while and decided, okay, if I keep it this low.
He says it's strategically placed.
Oh, he does say.
Yeah.
Well, of course it is.
So I didn't even know Geraldo had a radio show.
Yeah,
where is his radio show?
News to me. I don't know. I think it's like online.
Oh, some kind of like podcasting or something?
And he has to shave down. Like,
sure.
It would be a big disaster of fucking hair there.
Well, look at the mustache. You got to assume that he's
got gray hair.
He could grow a lot of fucking hair, this guy.
Oh, God, right?
So Geraldo explains the selfie photo on his radio show while on the phone with Elliot Spitzer.
Oh.
Elliot Spitzer doesn't want to deal with this shit.
Yeah, he kind of keeps quiet.
Of course he does.
My
You're not
going to
hear anything from him.
And TV personality Eric Bowling, who's he? Do we know him?
I don't know, but he's the one that kind of...
he falls over a lot.
Started this.
Oh, jeez. Oof.
Oh, it's this dude.
What's his name?
Eric.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, he's in the gutter.
He's from the Five on Fox.
Five, yeah.
The Five?
Yeah.
The Five.
I'm the Five.
So, Eric, what did you think when you saw it? And do you think I still have a job?
I think you still have a job, I'm guessing. Here's what I thought. I tweeted immediately, what the ... ... And then why ... ...
Denny?
beep. Geraldo, I mean, of all the people you should know better. I mean, it would be you. Look what's going on with Anthony Weiner. You know everything about what's going on with Anthony Weiner. What were you thinking, my man? You're a friend. What were you thinking?
Remember, I stayed above my private parts with my...
You did. Barely.
I had a strategically placed towel there, but... Governor Elliot Spitzer speaks of hubris. The governor speaks of hubris. Hubris is when you make... you churn life for boredom or for ambition, or you just can't stand to have things organized and quiet, and you create a tumult in your life. And I think that there I was, 2:30 in the morning on Sunday morning, and I do the show Saturday night. I did a great show on black on black crime and race relations and the Trayvon Martin fallout and federal charges and
things
going on in these crimes in Boston and the death of a witness in the FBI custody. So I did that show, and I get there and I get home, and I'm all, and there's no one to talk to. Everyone's asleep, and you just sit around. I had a drink, and then I was I had taken that picture Saturday morning, and I was looking at it, just going through, and I said, I'm gonna tweet this thing. I look pretty good for a 70-year-old, and I think because I'm so old, people will cut me some slack. That they won't take it too seriously.
And I don't know, I just push the trigger. And then once you push the trigger, it's...
there for life.
Wow. It's there for life.
I don't have any problem with it. Just...
Not at all.
Yeah, I don't give a fuck.
You just picture him sitting there. Right. Ah, if you drink, ah, fuck it. I bet I could get some pussy by putting this picture out. Fuck it. So he was just kind of hanging out. With his rose-colored glasses.
Yeah, you probably thought a bunch of people were going to comment on how nice his body was.
Yeah.
And he didn't realize, because he was drunk.
Yes.
He didn't realize. It's one of those ideas you have at night, and then you wake up in the morning, and that's when you realize it's a bad idea.
Yeah.
But he actually did it.
I thank God I don't drink in the age of cell phones and Twitter.
Oh, my God.
What the fuck? It's only a cock. Everybody fucking has one.
I can imagine.
Holy. Look at Jimmy's eyes rolling. God. Yeah. You would be a problem.
Dude, I would. I can't imagine the things that would be going out of my Twitter. Oh, my God.
Dude, how close is he to the top of his fucking penis there?
Really close.
Like, real close, right? Yeah, That's what's weird about this, the picture.
Well, he wanted to really show
he
up.
He really likes that
bit.
V of his, huh?
Every bit of it.
You got to have the point in the V, or it's not a V, so you really got to move that towel down.
Plus, he knows the girls like that. That's just such a tease. Like, ooh, all I want to do is rip that towel down.
Oh, God.
Is he married these days? I know he, like... That shit comes and goes with him, I think.
He was a pussy hound at one point.
Yeah, no
right?
kidding, man.
He fucked everyone.
Man, you just lose muscle mass at that age. Like, look at his shoulders and stuff and his arms. It's like, it doesn't matter what you do.
But he's 70.
That's what I mean, but, you know.
All right. But if he turned around, his ass would be completely exposed. That's how low the towel is.
For you and your fantasies.
Yeah, you see that asshole. He's got hair on
it. It says he's married. It says he's been married since 2003. Yeah. Why wasn't his wife hanging around? Why was he so lonely that he had to take photos of his
They were
almost
sleeping.
Dick?
He said it. They were sleeping.
Geraldo was lonely.
I was lonely.
He was lonely. Damn. Well.
Man, this is the first hour and a half of this show exhausted me.
It's exhausting.
Between the Anthony Weiner and Carlos Danger and the Geraldo thing and the readings.
My dick hasn't gone down once yet.
You gotta wonder what politicians in the past would have tripped over their own dicks on cell phones and everything. Kennedys probably would have done something.
Oh my God.
People would have been all over the Kennedys.
Send me a picture of your cunt, Mimi. Oh, immediately.
Mimi Beardsley.
Dearest Mimi.
Even Clinton. Yeah, imagine if Clinton had a cell phone.
Yeah.
What?
I think he sent one email when he was in the White House.
That's right.
Yeah, only one email.
There's a cockpit.
Yes, this big cockpit.
What was the one email he sent?
I want to bang you so hard that your tits smack off your face.
He was smart enough, though, although he did come on that dress. And even smart people get caught up in this shit.
Right.
Wiener's a smart guy, but man, when you're fucking pumping your dick, brains don't mean anything.
No.
They're calling A-Rod in the paper today the most hated person in baseball.
Yeah, absolutely.
He is a piece of shit. The Yankee organization can't even fake it anymore that they don't hate this guy. Like, I love when they put out statements and they might take a jab at him and then they're like, no, we appreciate everything Alex has done for the team and he's a part of the Yankee family. Now they don't even fucking
Because he's a
give
choke
a
artist and a selfish dick.
I fear no reprisals.
Seinfeld.
Yeah.
Got what I knew.
When he was dragging around the fucking World Series trophy.
Just doesn't seem like a nice guy. He seems like an arrogant twat who chokes. If he was fucking Mr. October, Reggie Jackson.
Oh, the Reggie.
At least fucking hit home runs in October. This bag of shit grounds into a double play whenever you need him in the eighth inning.
Yeah.
He stinks.
Fuck him.
And fuck him.
They're talking maybe a fucking lifetime ban from the game.
Well, I think what's happening is that's going to happen because the sports guys all know, like they have inside sources, and they're. I think everyone's surprised it hasn't happened yet.
Yeah,
they're just sitting there going, "Hello, this is happening. We all know it. So when are they going to pull the trigger on it? Maybe by the end of the week, he'll get a lifetime ban from baseball.
That'd be great.
That's fucking. That's
he's
harsh.
A dirty Seattle Mariner. He always will be. Fuck him and Edgar Martinez and Jay Buhner.
Yes, I'm a Mariner.
I've been farted.
Wow. Really got into that one.
And fucking all Randy Johnson and that whole...
Randy Johnson.
That whole fucking shitty Yankee.
You don't like the Mariners, huh?
Hate those motherfucking 90s Mariners. Murdered the Yankees. Yeah. Every West Coast trip, the fucking Yankees would go 2-8.
Yeah.
They'd be fighting it for first with Boston. They'd be fucking 2-8. They'd come back 6 games out of first. I want the whole West Coast to fucking fall into the ocean. Oh, I hated it. Cunt Mariners. Oh, that Randy Johnson is a fucking bag of shit.
Oh, he stopped and took a picture with you.
No, he didn't.
Oh, that's right.
Fucking lurch.
Yeah. Bill Madden in the Daily News today, sports writer, his headline, most hated player ever, they're starting to call him.
Not more than Ty Cobb. He's not hated more than Ty Cobb was. He threw shit on the field.
And they're all hinting, Major League Baseball is juiced to get rid of A-Rod for good. They all know that is happening, but they just don't know when. For whatever reason, but they're coming after him. It's always, and this is the picture you always get it of A-Rod, that smirk of.
It's amazing. You look at someone like Jeter, who fucking, you know, no controversy, fucking all around good guy, charitable, fucking amazing player.
Hateable.
And then he's beloved.
Yeah.
He's beloved.
Mariano Rivera.
Mo.
Crowds in Boston were giving him a standing ovation over the weekend because, you know, because he's retiring. And,
and he's amazing.
And everybody's showing him the respect that he deserves. I hate the Yankees, but there's no possible way you can't respect him as the greatest closer of all time.
I'm not following baseball this year. Like, he comes back from the injury. Is he having a good season? I don't even know. Ooh. Rivera.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. He's as dominant as ever.
Isn't that amazing?
It's because
he was ready to leave, and then he gets that horrendous injury, and he said, fuck, I can't leave this way.
He's as good as he's ever been.
Wow, really?
Maybe he stays another year. Who the fuck knows?
No, he's done.
Why?
He's done.
Because he's done.
He just wanted to come back and show. He wanted to go out in his own terms.
He didn't want to retire on an injury.
Right, right.
You know? Like, he
was a bad injury, man.
Yeah, I mean, it cost him the season.
Do you think he will be in the Hall of Fame?
I don't know, maybe.
You think they retire his number?
Yeah, but actually, technically it's already retired.
Oh, 42, right, Jackie.
Yeah.
Shit.
Last one.
But the Yankees fans are done with A-Rod, too?
Everybody is
done with A-Rod for years.
Yeah, for years. Everyone's done with A-Rod.
People hung in there for a while with A-Rod, though.
I hope he doesn't get banned. I hope the Yankees have to pay every penny of that contract.
Oh, really? God, no.
Yeah, you know what? I don't mind that either. Even though I was, you know, fuck him for making that terrible move.
Lifetime ban, what happens to his contract?
I don't know. I don't know how these deals work.
I'm sure there's some kind of clause in there where if you fuck up like that, you're out.
Absolutely.
Breach.
Or a clause like Aaron Hernandez when they cut him. It's got to be if you're arrested for a fucking homicide and charged, we don't have to pay you. There's some kind of morals clause.
You're sitting in prison getting fucking million-dollar checks from your team.
That's got to piss off the boys in the joint. Still getting paid, holy
fuck. Very popular at the commissary.
Right.
Yeah.
You ever just be grateful that, like, no matter how bad you've done things where, you haven't fucked up your life like that?
Oh.
Like, when you look at these guys who are in prison blowing $40 million, like, you dumb motherfucker. Nonsense.
Yeah, what is that about with Aaron Hernandez?
It's nonsense.
He's
utter
a
nonsense.
Fucking thug.
Yeah, he is a thug.
He's just a fucking thug who bamboozled everybody into thinking he was a football player.
I don't think playing football, you know, like, just makes him not a thug anymore.
So what you're saying is you can take that. Yeah, no, we.
Wow. All right.
Is that what I sound like?
Oh, I'm a Travis.
My horrible. Oh, okay.
You're talking about me.
I mistook.
Why don't we take a break? We got Joe Rogan coming in today.
Calling.
I'm sorry.
I was going to say.
That's
fuck.
Right.
I knocked Joe Rogan out.
I don't like the malls right now. It's really a little over the top and too much.
You think so? You think it's his hook and you don't like it?
Oh, it's his hook. It's his gimmick.
We're also flying to Montreal today.
Yes.
We're going to be live in Montreal tomorrow and Friday. Pretty excited about it. It's going to be great. Mm-hmm.
We haven't done one of these full show fucking field trips in a while.
At least
it's fucking
Chicago
cool.
Was the last one, right?
Yeah, right.
That's about a year ago.
Yeah.
And then the ONA podcast is available today, right? The new one?
Yeah.
Episode 11 we're up to. Please subscribe to the Opie and Anthony podcast. And we forgot about this bit that we're featuring this week.
What's the whole
Super Bowl saga.
Super Bowl, right.
Super Bowl.
We had a bunch of guys come in and just beat the shit out of their fucking testicles.
Right.
Basically.
Oh,
and then it ends with bees.
Wasn't that Tracy's last appearance?
Yes. Yeah. And the one thing you're going to hear on this podcast, I got to explain, the end of the podcast, I think it's a perfect ending, by the way. But in the old days, we used to be shut off by a master computer, and that day it worked out perfectly.
All right.
But that's why it ends how it ends. Remember? Because we actually ran out of time. They had a master fucking computer that at whatever time,
they
like 9:58,
switch us off.
And switches off. It didn't matter what we were doing.
That's right.
And we got it in just in time, and people were like, holy fuck, what a great ending.
The countdown.
Yeah, yeah.
What was the countdown noise?
Oh, yeah.
Well, we used to do Mario Brothers and other shit. And then what's the Opie and Anthony nugget? Well, I guess we keep that as a surprise.
No, it never
just flew out of Jimmy's ass.
Yeah, fucking...
Where do they get the podcast? What's the easiest way? iTunes?
iTunes. You just go to Facebook.
Yeah, but every day
Anthony.
I get people going, how do I get the pod? I don't understand these people.
It's
you
so
can't figure out how to get a podcast now?
I don't know how people don't figure out how to do anything. It's fucking online.
Right.
It's a fucking Google it.
Opie and Anthony.
Where is this? Where do you find that?
Right.
Who is that guy?
I just want to talk to you.
Yeah, I think
is that
so.
What that is?
That's all it is. They want to talk to you guys.
Yeah. Problem?
What happened, Jimmy?
Nothing at all. Nothing to do with what Sam's wearing.
Oh.
What? You don't like his Canadian pants? He's dressing for Canada today.
His fucking sockless shoes are enraging.
Let me
I
say.
Thought you liked socks, Sam. What happened?
Show him.
Not if you're wearing boat shoes.
Show him.
Boat shoes.
Fuck.
Holy shit, you got huge feet.
You really do.
Hello, fellas.
All the better to pop a quarter off those ankles.
Sure.
Are those shoes coming back?
Ankles.
I don't know. I'm bringing it back.
The boat shoes coming back?
You
they,
should.
They were popular when we were growing up. Coming up, Ed Balls. Who's Ed Balls? Ed Balls is coming up on Ed Balls.
Is that his name?
I'm Ed Balls.
Coming up, Ed Balls.
It's Carlos Danger's cousin.
Yes.
Ed Balls.
Yeah, he's like Bill Pekka.
You may want to be wet. He's huge for you today.
The Opie and Anthony Show on SiriusXM.